Welcome back, guys. I wanted to show you how to easily and quickly make a arrow on a Premiere Pro. I was drawing arrows before, but then I found out that you can just quickly pop one up and kind of manipulate it. So that's what I wanted to show you today. So I'm using Adobe Premiere Pro CS6. As you can see here, I've got the arrow here, so I'm going to show you how to make one. Okay, so what we're first going to do is we're going to go to title, new title, default still, and we're going to call it arrow 2. Okay, and what's going to pop up is this screen. We are going to press this tool type or the T here. And we're going to click it. You'll see that flashing there. Then we're going to hit Alt 26 at the same time. And let go. And you can see we got a little arrow there. So let's make it a little bit bigger there. We're going to go to the font size and we're going to just make it larger. If you want it longer, just go to the aspect and it'll make it longer or shorter. And all I'm doing is just hovering over the number here and left clicking, and you can see where it has the arrow. Let's see, you can see it has arrows over it, and just drag it left and right. Okay, what else? If you want to rotate it, come up to rotation, it'll rotate it. One. Okay, wherever you want. What's next here? Oh, there's something that I found here. It's called, makes it look a little 3D-ish. That's what I say. And it's called Slant, right here. And if you see what happens here, watch the arrow as same thing, you just drag it over. See how it kind of gives it that 3D look a little bit? A little parametric view, I guess you would call it also. Anyway, so that was kind of interesting. You can play with the rest of these things here. If you wanted to change the color, just come down here, click it, and here's this little dot here. You can see we're in the white area. If we move it over the red area, you can see how this box here changes color. Okay. If you go to black, you can see how it goes black. Now, if you don't want any of these colors here, what you could do is see these little black bars on each side here. Just grab it, slide it up or down, right, until you get the color you want, and then just drag this dot over. If you want blue, see it turns blue. Let's go back up here and get red again. Okay, let's get some red in there. Maybe a little bit more red. There you go. And hit OK. Now it's turned red. Then what you do is just click it there, and you come up to your project tab here, and there it is, arrow 2. Then just grab it, left click, drag it over, and you can see, just hover this over it, and you can see we've got our arrow. Okay, so what else can we do with this arrow here? Well, here's a picture, the video that I did. And let's say we want to point an arrow to this bad looking lug nut. Let's say this is a bad lug nut and we want to point an arrow to it so your viewers can, see what you're actually talking about. So we just grab it, hover over the picture and put it on top of the picture. And you can see now we have the arrow, but it's not pointed correctly, right? Well, what you're going to do is double click it, and there's the arrow, and it's going to have the picture there. So then let's say, well, we want it maybe a little bit smaller, maybe not as big. Okay, let's say that's a good size, you said. Okay, and then we come over here to the selection tool, click it, and of course we can move it around. So you could put it like, right there if we wanted to. That way, you can say, That's where I want you guys to look at that lug nut there. But let's say there's something, you know, in the way here, and we need to move it out of the way. Again, selection tool. Say we move it out of the way. We had something here. We moved it out of the way. Now we can rotate it. Okay. And then we can use the selection tool there to get it up a little bit closer if we want. And there you go. Click it. And now you can see we have the arrow. We're exactly where you want it. And that's about it. What else? Yeah, I guess that's about it. So, yeah, I'm doing a lot of these little tips and tricks videos that I've learned, and just wanted to share it with you guys. Please like and subscribe, and of course, I'm going to do as much of these as I can. They're pretty quick to make, I guess. But there were, you know, these little things, you know, it took me a long time to learn them because, you know, I didn't have anybody to show me. So, again, I wanted to share my knowledge with you on YouTube, and hopefully you'll learn a little quicker than what I did. Anyway, again, like and subscribe. Talk to you later.